there can be a show in my living room once a year. And then also there, I mean, I had an interesting experience with Pledge because I was one of their casualties last year when they went under. But the people that funded my record were amazing. I had no idea how interested they would be in buying special stuff. Like, I go pick berries every year in Yucaipa and then make homemade jam. And I made my own labels, and they were my logo, and I used a name that was something from one of the songs that I wrote, and people loved it, and it was this cool personal thing that that is so indicative of my relationship with a cult following that I have that's been with me since I was 18 and grown up with me, and the new people that are coming in because my music changes and therefore my demographic changes with it. So I want to do that. I also want to interact, but on my terms. I want to have my own place to sell special things, not just the album. But I want to do it on my own because I don't, you know, the fact that people really showed up for me, raised enough money that this album that I made out of pocket was going to be funded and then some, and then Pledge took all my music with them when they went under. I mean, took all my... it was mine, but it was theirs.
Yeah.
And that's so, like, I want to be able to take control and do it on my own and then figure out who I'm going to hire from there, which would be, like, you know, physical distribution. Who's going to go to, FedEx every single day? That kind of stuff. That's a lot of work, too. I can't do everything, but it might be that I could take control over, you know, the main job, not be giving 15% for somebody to do what, like, I'm the one making all this stuff. Obviously, if I made the labels, I also stuck them, well, my mom and I did it, stuck them on, you know, it is, I'm doing this out of my house.
Putting my mom to work more, that's what I'm taking away from.
Exactly.
My mom's getting a call tomorrow.
I know. Seriously, if anybody deserves, my mom deserves like 50% of everything I do, and no one knows that. She's the one handing me my glossies to sign so that they don't get smeared.
But you know? So one of the things you could do, like, kind of to give fans a backstage look is, like, you know, take a little video or a picture of you and your mom doing it together, if your mom's up for it. You know, like, people love, okay, maybe she's not up for it.
But yeah, that
people
is
love
the truth.
Seeing that, like, no, did you know, really, my mom is the one who's helping me. Like, that,
exactly, and if I could do that, like you're doing it, in a controlled way.
Yeah, you so decide.
That, yeah, I decide what I'm putting out there so that I'm not overexposed and I'm not, I mean, I'm very introverted in real life. I'm faking it right now, but and I don't like that kind of attention. So if I could do that on my own terms, where I'm inviting people in to select things that are specific to the work I'm making, and not just like, hey, look at me, because please don't look at me is my usual, and you know, but also make special things, engage in a way that's like personal, and then, you know, it's gonna be that people listen to these songs and apply them to their own lives. So why don't I make it a part of their own life before they even come out, so that they're already invited to do what I believe in, which is, like, why would I tell you what the song is about? That's up to them. That they should make it their own. So it can be their own from day one, but I want to be in control of that so that no one ever runs away with my money again.
I think our moms need to meet, because my mom is just as much of a superwoman.
People don't know that. Behind every great woman is another great woman.
Yeah. I will say another good resource that's been helpful to me is if you can find, like, a local college that has a marketing program, a music business program.